Welcome to the video series of object-oriented programming using Java. Myself, I'm Alisha. I'm going to cover the topic interface hierarchical inheritance in this video lecture. And this is the part of unit number 3, inheritance and interfaces. Now you people are already knowing the interface and inheritance, simple inheritance. In previous video lecture, I have covered the code and syntax, an example of simple inheritance using interface. Now think about this thing for the hierarchical inheritance in interfaces. Can we implement hierarchical inheritance using interface in Java? Can we provide dynamic method dispatch concept that we have covered using abstract classes in abstract classes? Can we provide this with the interfaces in Java? And what about the multiple inheritance? So to provide the multiple inheritance, again we need the interface inheritance. So this thing you can provide by using the interface inheritance concept. So let's talk about interface and hierarchical inheritance. Now first of all, tell me, what is hierarchical inheritance? This I have covered in my video lecture of types of inheritance. Now hierarchical inheritance having more than one child, or you can say more than one classes have the common parent. That means many classes are derived from common class. This inheritance is called as a hierarchical inheritance. Here, this is the example of hierarchical inheritance. In hierarchical inheritance, animal is an interface. I have written it in an italic letter. This UML symbol of rectangle and italic text letter is a symbol of the interface. Now I'm going to implement this animal interface in these two child classes. One is cat and one is dog. So in these two classes derived from, implements from animal interface. So here more than one child's, more than one siblings is siblings are available, and common parent for more than one class is available. So this is the example of hierarchical inheritance. Now for that, you have already done this thing. First, implement interface animal. We have already done. We have already created the cat class, which is implements from animal interface. And inside that, we have already implemented this save function. And save function behaves printing meow meow for all the cat object, right? Now for the hierarchical inheritance, this new class you have to add, class dog implements animal. This class dog implements animal. At that time you have to override publicly void save function. Now think about it, how we have this save function in dog class. The dog says bow wow. So you have to implement the save function in dog class with the implementation of printing bow wow. So here this is the concept of overriding. You are defining the structure in super interface, and only you are just declaring the structure. What is the function name? What is the return time? And what is the parameter? What will be the parameter of the function? Child class defines it in its own way, so that function behaves differently for each and every class. Now, when function behaves differently, this provides the polymorphism mechanism in Java. So here, this interface always gives the polymorphism mechanism overriding. Function name is same, behave differently in different class, right? Now this Now let's talk about the dynamic method dispatch concept. We have already done in abstract class concept. Now, whenever you need the dynamic method dispatch concept, you must have the hierarchical inheritance. This is the example that I have already explained you in previous slide. Now, whenever you are making the reference variable of animal interface, and just assign the object of cat class and assign the object of dog class to this reference variable of animal class and just call the save function, you will get the different output whenever you are assigning the different object to common reference variable of an animal. For that, you have to create one demo class, interface demo, and you have to create public static void main to provide the dynamic method dispatch concept and to demonstrate the dynamic method dispatch concept. Now in main function, I am going to create the reference variable of super interface animal like this animal an. So here this an is a reference variable. Now keep in mind the property of interface, we cannot create the object of interface, but we can create the reference variable of an interface like this: super type, then variable name, then colon. Super type is animal and an is a variable name. Now try to assign the object of cat class to this an reference variable. The super class variable can refer child class instance that I have already covered. So here this cat is a child class and I am going to assign the object of cat class to this super class variable an. Now just try to call this function an.save. Now whenever you are calling the an.save function, your runtime, JVM runtime, first find where this an refers. This an refers currently to the cat object. So that whenever you are making the function call on an say, it always refers to current class instance. That's why it calls the cat class save function, not dog class dog class save function, right? So here you will get the output, the save function of cat. Inside my code, the cat class having save function implementation system.out.println meow meow, and you will get the output meow meow. Now I can assign the object of dog class to this an variable also. So let's assign the object of dog class to an variable because it dog is also a child class of this animal interface. So super class variable can refer subclass instance. This concept is covered over here. Now try to call the function an.say. Now whenever you are making the call, your an is currently refers to object of a dog class, so it invokes the function say of a dog class, and the say function in dog class prints bow wow. So here you will get the output bow wow. So here the same syntax an.say prints different output because this an always refers to current object instance, and this instance refers dynamic instance refers dynamically when you run your program, right? So we are changing this reference of an dynamically in our program. First we are assigning cat object, then we are assigning dog objects. That's why this in reference variable refers, reference is changing dynamically, and based on that this function is invoked. This dynamic method dispatch is provided by using the concept of hierarchical inheritance as well as by concept of overriding runtime polymorphism. So this is basically runtime polymorphism. We are overriding the function of a super class in child class. Super class only having the declaration and child class having the definition, right? So this is the concept of overriding. Now let's try to code this hierarchical inheritance. For that, I'm going to open my Notepad++ over here. This is my Notepad++. I'm going to use the previous program that I have already created, animal interface class get, and this interface main having the main function, right? Now, for the hierarchical inheritance, you need to create more than one child class from the common parent. So here I'm just copying the code and I'm going to create the another class dog implements from animal interface. Now this class must have to override this save function of a super interface. So here I'm going to override public void save, but the save function of a dog class prints wow, right? Now just create the reference variable of animal class, animal interface in main, animal an. This is the reference variable of kind animal. Now assign the child class instance new cat, cat class instance. Cat is a child class and I'm going to assign the object of a cat class to this an reference variable. Now try to make a call an dot say. I'm making the function call. I'm saving this file. Now I'm going to open the command prompt. For that, open the command prompt. Move in your drive, D drive, CD, O, PJ, programs. Now, Java C. Then give the file name. File name is interface-demo.java. Interface-demo.java. It's going to compile. It will take some time. Code is successfully compiled. Now try to run a Java, then give the class name. Class name is interface main. Interface main. Remove the dot class. So see here, we are getting meow meow because this an refers currently this object of a cat class, right? Now let's try to refer a dog class instance by the an variable. So I'm just copying these two things, but I'm changing the reference of an variable to the object of a dog class like this, right? And I'm going to call the function an.say now. Now what it should print for the second time? See, the syntax is same, but the reference of an changed to the dog class object, right? I'm going to save this file, going to open the command prompt, and in this command prompt I'm recompiling the code and run it again. See here, I'm getting the bow wow, right? Now you can do the same thing by using the object reference of cat class also like this. I'm just creating cat class object like this, cat c equals to new cat, and here I'm creating object dog d equals to new dog. And before calling the function an.say, I'm just calling it like this, this an equals to c. So this is the same thing that I have done previously. And here I can write like this, an equals to d, right? And save it and open the command prompt. Try to compile it again and try to run it. You will get the same output. So you can use the different syntax to provide the dynamic method dispatch concept. You can do it by using this way also, right? Now tell me what happen if I'm not going to assign this value to an variable. So currently this an is not assigned, nothing is referred by the an. So here you will get the output like this. Or let me open the command prompt first. I'm going to open the command prompt. Now try to compile this code. See here, we are getting the compile time output. Variable an is not initialized and used by an.save function. This error you can remove by assigning null like this. So this compile time error you can remove by assigning null to this object, and try to compile it now. So it will be compiled, because Java local variable need the assignment before use of it, right? So here in an.save we are using it. So before using we have to assign something. So here you will get runtime error, null pointer exception, because this an refers to nothing, that's why. So here I'm just going to, it compiles successfully, but it generates the runtime error, null pointer exception, because this an refers to null, this 24 number line having the error, right? So you must have to assign something to an before using the save function, right? See here in code, the 24 number line having this use of this an variable. That's why we are getting this error. So hope you people are clear with the concept of hierarchical inheritance and dynamic method dispatch. I'm going to end this session now. Hope you people like this session. Thank you for watching my video, and I will cover the remaining topic or continuous topic in my next video lecture. Thank you all of you.